What is up, bros and broettes? It's Inkslasher44, and today we're going to be talking about the Devil's Lair Strike Nightfall mission. Still, as always, I go through these and show you the easiest way to kind of cheese your way and get through the Nightfall mission the easiest for that specific week. We are getting close to doing all of these. I think we have three left after this one, but there's some pretty sweet spots you can use on this strike mission that I'm going to show you today, and it'll help you get through this thing pretty damn easily. The hardest part is actually right at the beginning. So right here where we are right now is where the strike mission really begins. So we come in here and we just have to fight through these minions. There really isn't that many. The next section is where it gets hard. So the next section is actually a fight between the Fallen and the Hive. Now what you have to do is, as you're going to see here, there are three waves of enemies that are going to happen. The easiest place to go is the spot where you see us right here. From here you can use your weapons and snipe the enemies with very little bullets flying at you. You have the cover off to the left here, and off to the right you can pretty much shoot everything. Now you gotta be careful, especially on this Nightfall, because light switches on, which means you die in a single beatdown, and enemies can jump up here. So just constantly be aware of your radar, make sure nothing is jumping up here. Now once you've reached the third and final wave of these things, you gotta be really careful. First of all, some of these things randomly teleport behind you, and like I said, light switches on. So you gotta make sure you're paying attention to your radar once again, and just making sure nothing teleports behind you and hits you. Also, the final named boss, so the named yellow captain that spawns in at the end, he will literally run towards you and jump up onto that ledge that I'm standing on here. As you can see right here, the way we took care of it is I shot my rocket launcher, and the person, the Titan that I was playing with, used his seismic slam, and he watches my videos and gets really pissed off when I call it the wrong name, so I'm just going to continue to call his powers the wrong name because it's hilarious. But that's the easiest way to get through those three waves. So as far as general strategy we used when approaching this strike mission is, well, first of all, two things. So we approached it very passively, knowing it was probably going to take us probably about 20 to 25 minutes, which it did. It took us about that long. But on top of that, we used a couple special weapons. So since there was arc damage this time, we used Patience and Time was the sniper rifle we chose because it does a crap load of damage and it's a very good arc sniper rifle. On top of that, I was using an arc rocket launcher, and as you're going to notice, he was using just a primary weapon that puts out a lot of DPS, where I was using a primary weapon that does solar damage. Reason being, when you fight the shanks in this, they have a solar shield, and they're very hard for him to take out because his auto rifle was doing pretty much peanuts to them, whereas my weapon would do so much damage to them because it would really take out their solar shields really quickly. So that was kind of the general strategy we were using. So the next two sections you're going to get to in this part, both are kind of boss fights. The next section you're going to watch right here is the spider tank boss fight, and this is, that's what I like to call it. So there is a very easy way. So if you go to this window where I am here, you can get very easy shots onto the tank without him being able to do very much damage at all to you. On top of this, you're going to want to be careful because there is a captain and a vandal that spawn in above you on the roof, and they will jump down and shoot you. So just have one person kind of paced back a little bit, just watching for him to jump down. That's kind of what we did. On top of that, there is a arc damage weapon on the strider that you can actually shoot off. It's on the top part of it. It's kind of a separate gun than the main gun. You can see it off to the left right there. So that's, you can shoot that thing off, and then you don't have to worry about him doing arc damage to you whatsoever. But aside from that, just watch out for the captain and vandal, and shoot his legs. It's that easy, and you can just do a ton of damage to him so fast. It only took us about 2 minutes to beat him. Once you've completed this section, once you've defeated the tank, you're going to want to clear out all the enemies in this area and then pick up as much ammo as you can before you move on to the next boss. So the final boss fight is against Sepix Prime, a giant looking eye that somehow looks like it has a mutated form of pink eye that turned it purple. But the best way to beat this thing is to, you're going to see us go off to the left over here and kind of just stay in this room off to the left. This room is a really special room. So if you stay in this room, nothing will spawn in this room. It's really hard for them to shoot to you and really easy for you to shoot to them. And actually, Sepix Prime will teleport so that it is very easy for you to get critical shots on him, because he'll literally just stare at you with his giant eye and make it very easy for you to shoot him. It takes a little longer to do it this way, but it's very safe, and there's very little risk of getting downed. Now, there is something that I'd like to quickly say. First of all, if someone stays in the back hallway where you kind of go into this area, things will spawn in this room, but only if you stay in that introduction hallway where you come into this area. If you stay out of that area, nothing will spawn in this left room, period. And it is very, very easy to defeat Sepix Prime doing this. So like I said, just stay off to the left in this room, kill adds when you need to, and just do as much damage to the pink eye ridden eye when you can. So that's all I got for you. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and hit me up with a like rating. I hope you enjoyed. And until next time, guys, peace out.